Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Legends. Today we are playing a Redoran conscription deck that I just brewed by myself in the backyard using God knows what utensils, haunted cauldrons, and some magic dust. So, yeah, the idea of this deck is to run conscription on turn 10, 11 without the ring, have loads of fun, and don't forget to journey. Ooh, and use commander whenever in hand. Now, commander has not been used so much until recently. And it's the best card for conscription. Why? Because it gives +1/+1 to all other creatures in the deck. Now, if you already lost a hefty amount of 2-cost creatures, you can always use Journey, be it you have it in your hand. And by journeying those creatures, you'll just see an amazing lineup whenever you conscript. Let's get on with our match here. We're playing against Cazador91, playing a sorcerer deck. We're not sure if it's mid-range or could be everything else sorcerer. Could be late game sorcerer, could be dragon sorcerer, could be a lot of things. Right now we need to gain many cards as possible. A rapid shot. So far, so good. We have 2 Dushnik Yell Archers, and we've got Dawnbreaker. Now, Dawnbreaker, in combination with guard creatures and Breakthrough. Sorry, Breakthrough on our side of the board and guard creatures on our opponent's side of the board can just prove fatal. That depends on how soon we draw a Praetorian Commander and how soon we can conscript. The idea of this deck is not to play very aggressive because you want to survive until turn 10 or 11 if you have the ring. 10 if you have the ring, actually. Right now, there's not much we can do except play another Fifth Legion Trainer. Let's draw us another card, Feasting Hunger. Feasting Hunger gains a lot of HP for you, especially if you're playing against another conscription deck. If you manage to drop Feasting Hunger when a board is full, you get 8 HP, just like that. Wow. Okay, so there's the Praetorian Commander. Now breaking the ward on that 1-1 will just cause 2-5-5 Atronachs with guard, one in each lane. We have no silence. So I'll just think. I think I'll go to go with face. We will apply 13 damage our opponent with just 8 HP. Let's fill up some board presence of our own. If you play this deck correctly, you can fill the lanes with stuff pretty fast, even without conscription, which can prove overwhelming for the opponent. As of now, we'll just see two Aatrox. There they are. Oh damn. Cazador 91, you did not calculate that properly. That's two lava Aatrox, one in each lane. This can prove difficult, but not for us. Because that Rithane 6-2 gets the Dawnbreaker and breaks for 9. Good game. So first match ended quite fast. Didn't manage to reach conscription. Let's see if we're lucky in our next one. Good starting hand. What? Prepare to die? What? Gold deuce. Why are you speaking nonsense? Ooh, Praetorian Commander right off the bat. We also have an Oracle. It's the only Oracle, and I think I'll just replace it with something else. Because I don't know, if it does not fare well, it has no place in this deck. Even though we have some drain creatures, like the Redrun Forerunner and Battle Stalker, and we can also use Feasting Hunger to get HP. I don't know, it's just one card among 75, and there's a high chance of not getting it when you actually need it. So, so far we're playing Mirror. Let's get that Dark Guardian up. Let's deny him the extra draw. Elusive Schema. Well, goodbye. Let's draw another card. Emperor's Blade. Should I test my luck or use Morgue Tongue? Maybe we can draw conscription and get it to 0. That would be awesome. A 0 cost conscription is just amazing. Well, he did not attack, which means we have more draw capabilities on our hands. So dropping the Morgue Tongue was an inspired move. Emperor's Blade should provide enough protection. Enderal Mastermind. Too bad we're stuck into the shadow lane and we're unable to follow up with Morgue Tongue. Okay, that's nice. So he's starting. Our opponent is starting to develop the field lane. Yeah, because the shadow lane is just dead for him. Oh boy, we've got so much stuff in our hand. What's cost that? No. Let's gain some HP. Make sure it does not die from a random lightning bolt. Opponent is down to 17. We've got quite the cards. And we also have the plays. Yep, just sacrifice it. Another Indril Mastermind. What? Why did he say it has been my honor? I don't know. Praetorian Commander it is. Going face. And no prophecy. Crushing blow. Oh, that was just overdrawn. Sorry, mate. So, we didn't play the even out Oracle. Dawn's Wrath. And Velocity Assassin. Well, I think we'll just we'll just trade. We're trying to put some creatures down. Why not gain some extra HP? Another card goes away. It was Chitara this time. Nahagleave. And execute. And a Barostalker. Board is starting to fill up with a lot of heavy creatures. Nothing we can do about it, Nahagleave. So our best bet at the moment is to get rid of those Shadowlane Protectors. Actually, well, we do get to play Ebonheart Oracle. Why waste a 2-cost boosted? Let's use the Redoran Forerunner to get rid of the Nahagleave. Hopefully that Barostalker will trade with whatever finds available on the board. Yep, there it is. Opponent is down to 12. Managed to recover there some 12 HP. However, we are going to sip some beverage. And we are going to end up find a way to get lethal mode. Necromancer brings back Barostalker. Let's get rid of those necromancers because we don't like them at all. So Our opponent is now down to 8 HP, and with that Hive Defender, hopefully, we have sealed the deal. Here comes Odaving. Crap. Opponent is down to 3. Well, problem is, we're out of options. There's no conscription, there's no journey here. Most likely at the bottom of the deck. Now, I have spread my creatures as good as I could. And this attack by Odaving. Yep, wins us the match. Good game. And welcome back. Playing Redoran Conscription, or trying to get something conscripted. So far, no luck. Not because we've lost the matches, but because there has been no conscription whatsoever. Playing against a Tribunal, playing against IXX Anubis. No play so far. So we're just going to skip our turn here. 5th Legion Trainer. So far we have no way to remove that. So Barrass Socket it is. Hopefully we'll be able to Crusader Assault into that. Fortunately, a Shrieking Harpy comes along. So it looks like we have to figure a way to better guard this, and what better guard than Tyr. So the good thing is, we've got a Tree Minder. Not the 5th Legion Trainer. Where have you been? Where are you coming from? Get back in the deck. Oh boy. Let's cast that into time. We don't want to have any more 5th Legion Trainers on the board. So our best bet right now is double 5th Legion Trainer. Ooh, Rapid Shot. Excellent. It's exactly the card I was waiting for. One way or another. The good thing is we get to play our Crusader's Assault. Only 1 HP left on Tyr. There goes a Firebolt. Let's get a 5th Legion Trainer. And at least Marsh Crusader. And that's a nice storm. Great. Why do I keep drawing 2 costs? Because there's so many, we may have nothing to conscript. No, just kidding, we've got plenty. Training is over. It's time to act. So I'm thinking some pretty hard removals. Execute Shadowfin Priest. Add Velocity Assassin. So dilemma. Let's cast that into time. No more silencing effects. Add Velocity Assassin and Edict. Here comes Praetorian Commander. Praetorian Commander sets us up real nicely. That's 12 damage on the field. Needed to win. Only 6 damage that can be applied. And that conscription, though. Don't worry. We have a conscription next turn, immediately. We need to kill off some of these. Let's get rid of that. If you can. Let's see if we can fill the board with exactly what we need. That's not good. We've got an important card unguarded on nothing. It's just going to sit there and die. Except the Praetorian Commander and Brumal Profiteer, everything else is kind of omelette. Reverberating Strike, yeah, getting rid of those. And a Cast into Time. And the Lightning Bolt. So our opponent was holding that many actions. Seems legit. Don't worry, we've got another Praetorian Commander. So right now, every 2-cost creature still inside the deck has somewhere around +2/+2. Now, if we could get a journey. No journey. Just another conscription. Damn, that's some heavy damage. Ooh, Dushin to kill Archer. So predictable. Don't let him break our lines. To hell with it. Let's play our second conscription. And we get some pretty good stuff out of our deck. Da. And our veteran forerunner has just been shackled. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh, there's another Tullius conscription. On our opponent's side as well. Ooh, that's good because the Broom of Profiteer was near the last summons. Our opponent gained just a little bit just a little bit of HP. And we beat the second conscription.